So Gable's the man to beat at the moment, but the next skater certainly will make a run at the top spot. Johnny Weir, the 20-year-old from Lancaster, Pennsylvania, won the title last year, and he's quickly become one of the top names in the world. If he keeps progressing at the current pace, not only could you see him on the podium, maybe the top step at Worlds, but who knows, maybe at the Olympics in 2006. Here he is. Has been in the past an extremely easy and clean jump. This time he had to fight for that landing. Very close. Very satisfactory. Wonderful position. Number of turns required on each foot there. He had two big wins in the Grand Prix Series, international events this year, but then was forced to withdraw from the Grand Prix final because of a foot injury. He now says that's 100%, completely healed. Circular footwork that continues to flow. Good speed, good turns in both directions. Again, a very, very sort of stumpy landing. Straight line footwork follows the music beautifully. He's a wonderfully complete skater. He really has all of the elements going. This was not his best time with the jumps. Both of the two major jumps had struggling on the landing. Didn't have the usual flow out, the wonderful speed and element that he had coming up. Just not good.
Tim Gable, a smile on his face now. He's able to watch. Had to fight through some jumps, but Johnny Weir did get through them. The reigning champ, his effort here in the short.
Normally his jumps so easy and clean, this one too, but right here, watch the fight on the landing. Did not check the left shoulder to stop the rotation. And this triple Lutz, triple toe combination, right here, the landing smooth and easy and into the next one, but again. Now, in this straight line footwork, you can see how he moves forward into the music. He follows it. It's a continuous flow, and that's good. Turns both to the right and the left. Toe work as well of all kind of changing edges there. Slows down a little bit at the end.
5-7.
Now, we saw the 6.0 for Evan Lysacek for presentation. And remember, this probably is the last year we're going to see it at the U.S. Nationals. Not only there for required elements. In fact, the low mark is 5.3. Of course, that judge could just be consistently. Well, there it is. There's a 6.0, Dick.
Well, that was a wonderful gift. I've never quite understood how you could have a perfect six if you fell down. Even that movement was not beautifully done. But, I mean, he had a couple of breaks in it, and that, of course, I think slowed it down.
More importantly, the judges' placements and a couple of threes there, but four ones. Overall, Johnny Weir's in second. He's right behind Tim Gable, who just now realizes that he still has the lead. So here are your standings after the short. Gable, Weir, and Lysacek, your top three. It's extremely important in the old six.